What's up, Super Crews? DC Song coming back to you. Good to see you. Hope you all had a wonderful week. Here for another unboxing, believe it or not. I'm trying to make this a regular series, as I mentioned in the previous video in which I was doing a lot of rambling. Mentioned that I will be doing an unboxing for a lot of the stuff that I actually own, whether it be, you know, just acquired it or got it a little while ago, because I usually don't unbox anything in my house, especially if it's a collector's item. But at the same time, can't really enjoy it unless you take it out of the box and see what it's like for some items. On the opposite side, there are some things that I really do want to unbox so I can show and share with you all, as well as some of the unique items that I've had the chance to design myself or had some type of collaboration going on at one point or another. I will be doing a culture review of my own until we get the scheduling things worked out with Coco and do more for their actual channel. So these will actually be on my channel, as well as a review for Hot Toys. And today, believe it or not, Hot Toys it is. So I have a couple things, but first thing I want to show is the Arkham City Batman. For those who don't know, Hot Toys came out with several versions of Batman in general, and one of them was the Arkham City Batman. And this particular Batman was designed by yours truly. I'll explain in a moment and definitely show you guys. There was an event they had here in Japan, Tokyo, for the Suicide Squad and Batman movie promotion last year, and I have misplaced my cutter. We'll deal with that in a second, but anyway, maybe. Haha! Behind the computer. Don't ask why I keep doing my radio voice. Anyways, so long story short, I tend to get the chance to do some design work or type of design for an event often here in Japan, and Hot Toys has been gracious enough to let me do that since they've been doing their events, in which I have to say thank you very much, company of the other times. I love doing these, it's fantastic. This particular one was for the event that I designed, and I had an idea of taking two characters or two character ideas, mashing them up to kind of bring in the storylines that they had going on that also match with the event. Now, for this one, they had four different base models of Batman that you can choose from, and then put your own original design to it. So a lot of celebrities here were asked to do those kinds of things, and I was one of them, and I will share with you now. Want to open it, but then I'm having second thoughts because it's one of a kind. I don't really want to take it out of the box, but I'm going to take it out for you all. So first, this is the actual box itself. They have the Arkham City Batman logo right, and it goes all the way around. The Arkham City logos, and oh man, this is just, I like the box art on this because it's that muted gray and black. It's not really vibrant colors and stuff, not that Batman is or should be, but then even this side of the box is completely different texture from this. This is like kind of grainy, so it's really cool and it really fits. The boxes for most of the Hot Toys statues are actually, or figures, are magnetic. So that's something I really like about it, because it's almost like opening a collector's box, so to speak, or a treasure. So when you open the box itself, it has the Batman Arkham City logo, background scene, and a little bit about the figure itself here. As you can see, this is completely different from what's in the game, for obvious reasons. the actual logo and design that I did for this didn't fully get painted on here because at the time Warner and DC asked that they not have the logos modified, in which, out of respect, you just don't. If it did, would have been even cooler than it already is, which says a lot because this is amazing. This is one of my favorites, and not because it's like, oh, I designed it kind of thing, because it looks really good and they did a fantastic job of painting it. So the long box, pull this out. So just like the other boxes, once you take it out, there's other box art that's inside. And it's really cool. It basically looks like, that's cool. It's detective mode that's from the inside of the box. Like, it's detecting what's inside. Ooh, so exciting. Okay. And the room's cool. Alright. Base. Oh yeah, that's right. They have it on there. I'll show you this. Okay, so the booklet that's for the actual Batman Arkham City. And then the fun begins. So as you can see, we've got his grappling gun, his detecting device, his batarang, more attachments for his battering and weaponry. Oh, that's really cool. There are several weapons and things in here. You can actually change the face around. You can't change the face in this one because it's actually there are 7 hand attachments. Yeah, 7 hand attachments that are in here. That is really cool. I'll give you a look in the plastic. And the concept behind this was, because of the lead into Justice League and anything else, which we won't go into movie-wise, some people like it, some people don't, besides the fact, I don't care. At this point, what's done is done. But there are parts of the movie that I did like, so you know, whatever. For the figure itself, I actually did this design this way because he's looking at it as, hey, Batman will actually need upgrading his armor. So instead of using earthly tech all the time and trying to come up with his own stuff, him and Superman collaborated, and Superman basically gave him Kryptonian armor that'll help him with their battle against Darkseid and any other forces. Oh my gosh, this looks cool. Okay, so the back of this figure has, that's right, ladies and gentlemen, a cape. And the cape is actually wrapped up. I don't know if I can pull that out. There's some plastic. That came out. No big deal. Anyways, the hands. Wow, that's really awesome. The hands are done in the same paint schemes. They actually painted all of them for me, which is even cooler. They are not half second place. Japanese would say Tekito, and they're not being Tekito about it. So like that. So I'm gonna take Batman out. Doing that means he's gonna, the cape's coming right out that plastic. Ooh, that's even cooler. Okay. I gotta show you guys this before I show you the figure. Sorry. Dragging out just a bit. So, the figure itself comes with a base plate that actually says Batman Arkham City on it. And it looks like this, but actually has a print on it. This one with no print is what I'm going to use and keep this in the box. But the cape that's on the backside is actually in plastic that's taped to this to protect it. While it's in the box. Wow. Ooh! Tippy-tippy! Alright, so anyways, here is your Batman Arkham City version. There's Batman's back muscles. The cape is real material. One of the things I like about the Hot Toys figures is they actually use real materials for their costumes as opposed to just simple plastics or whatever. Of course, there are pieces where they use simple plastics or whatever if that's what, you know, that particular figure calls for. But when it comes to the clothing and things, they actually do a really good job of putting it on as real clothing. The gauntlets are adjustable. You can move them, take them off, whatever. Cool. Take them off. The belt detail. Wow, that is amazing. I didn't get the chance to actually do anything with the figure after it was made. The detail that I drew out for this matches perfectly. I'll add a picture of the logo of how I was going to have it done, almost like a glyph. It didn't make it to the final cut, obviously, but this still looks amazing, and for that, I thank you. That is my chin. I'll take a picture and show you guys, but let me know what you think. Do you all have Hot Toys figures? What do you think of Hot Toys? Do you have one that you're looking forward to see coming out? Also, the base, which I should have mentioned earlier, apologies for that, are adjustable for height, and when you adjust them higher, they expand, so it actually holds the weight of the figure, which is cool. These can be taken out, and they can be put right back in and readjusted. It's awesome. All kinds of awesome. Man, Batman looks cool. So anyways, I will do another unboxing for Hot Toys soon. Let me know if there's a figure for Hot Toys that you would like me to unbox, and I will see about getting that up as soon as possible. In the meantime, list your characters down below. Let me know what you think, questions, comments, anything that you would like me to review from Hot Toys. Let me know sooner than later, because I will try and do two or three if I can at one time and show you guys. Also, because of the Comic-Con and other events that are coming up soon, it may be difficult to do that. So in the time being, I will get out as much as possible. Hey, Super Crew, just quick recap. Just letting you know that with the Hot Toys figures, that they are fully posable. They have attachments for almost every single one that they make. So you can interchange the hands, some parts of the costume, masks if they have masks, put on a maskless face onto the character if that's what is available. Price points for these, depending on which figure you're looking at, I'd say on average is about $200-$300. Reason being, because they do a actual scan of that actor or actress, and when they make it, it pretty much looks like that person. Outside of the detail and quality that goes into it, they're using real materials, and a lot of it is hand sewn. Some of it is done by machine, but some of it is also hand sewn, hand painted, and things of that nature. So there's a lot of quality and time that goes into making these. Also, they're usually limited editions because they're not done in super mass production where there's like hundreds of thousands of them. You may be looking at just a few thousands or a few hundreds depending on that particular project or whatever. But just wanted to let you guys know this was one of my absolute favorites from Hot Toys, not just because I was able and honored to design it, but because this character and this design for the character is actually one of my favorites. The Batman Arkham City design is fantastically done, in-game as well as out of the game, and I will be looking for a red hood so I can add that to the collection, but also so I can try and unbox it for you guys. So for those that haven't seen it, I'll be doing that for you sooner than later. And if not, I will have plenty of other Hot Toys merchandise to unbox for you guys. Leave a comment and list down below what you would like me to unbox for you, whether it be from the Arkham series, Wonder Woman, Batman, Superman, Justice League, Star Wars, doesn't matter. If it's Hot Toys, I'm in. Sideshow also, because that's also kind of the same company. I'm going to be doing a Green Lantern unboxing for the Hot Toys / Sideshow version of Hal Jordan soon as well. Until then,